In today's video, we're going to be using radio astronomy to measure the temperature of the sun. We're going to have three main steps. The first step is to get the diameter of the sun. We're going to use a small hole in a piece of paper and some basic geometric optics to calculate that. And then we're going to get our background readings. We're going to use the satellite dish to get the voltage and temperature of the ground, the voltage and temperature of the sky. And then finally, we're going to use the satellite dish to get the voltage and temperature of the sun. Okay, so all we've done here is punched a small hole in the piece of paper. The size of this hole needs to then be measured and recorded. Okay, so we take our piece of paper with the hole cut in it, we face it towards the sun, and I've put a piece of paper on the floor just to make it easier to see the image. The sun's then going to shine through the hole, which the size we've measured, and then we are going to measure the diameter of the image on the paper on the floor. We then also need to measure the distance between this piece of paper and the image on the floor. Now we're going to run through the apparatus used in the experiment. The main thing is the satellite dish. It's made up of two parts, obviously the satellite dish and the antenna. Important part to note is the focal point of the satellite dish. That is where all the radio waves that are incoming get focused into one single point, and that is located here at the antenna. The angle at which the satellite dish works is that all the radio waves come, reflect off, and then bounce here. When we're angling the satellite dish at our target, we must make sure that the shadow of this antenna doesn't interfere with the satellite dish at all, and that'll become important when we measure the temperature of the sun. We can then move on to the power supply. This is mainly just to convert the AC current into DC current, as all the components work off of DC current. We then have this gray box here, which is our square law detector. The square law detector takes the input voltage and gives out a voltage proportional to its square root. That's because power is directly proportional to voltage squared, and we need voltage directly proportional to temperature. We then have our multimeter, and this is going to be used to take our voltage readings. Generally, it's set to the millivolts scale because most of the readings we'll be taking are in millivolts. This is a close-up of our multimeter. I just wanted to emphasize that we're setting the multimeter onto 200 millivolts, as that is the range in which our values will generally lie. Okay, to get our voltage ground reading, the first thing we do is point our satellite dish towards the ground. It's important to note that the dish itself should not be in the sun. The sun should not be reflected inside the dish at all, and the ground at which we're pointing the dish should also not have any sun on it. To get our reading, we turn the mains on, and we'll see that the reading on the voltmeter fluctuates up and down. We give it about 10 to 30 seconds to see which value do all our values hover around, and we'll record that reading. You should not worry about temperature for the ground. That's been recorded already, and that'll be given to you. That's generally just going to be the average room temperature. Okay, to get our voltage sky reading, we do the exact same procedure as before, except this time we point the satellite dish towards the sky. The part of the sky that we point the satellite dish towards mustn't have a single building, cloud, or the sun in it, so we can just get all the background radiation that's being emitted. Okay, to get our voltage readings for the sun, the first thing we need to do is make sure we align our satellite dish correctly. We're going to move the trolley until we see the shadow of the antenna is in between the two pins in the middle of the satellite dish. Once we've done that, we then have to adjust it up or down so that the shadow of the antenna is no longer on the dish. As you can see now, there's no shadow on the dish. It's picking up all the radiation from the sun. Then to get our readings, all we have to do is turn on our mains. We'll see that the voltmeter or the multimeter starts picking up voltage. We need to record that reading every 30 seconds for 20 minutes.